Om Shanti and a very warm welcome to your own fitness formula. Last episode we spoke about the benefits of the fruit apple. Well, I've included apple in my fruit basket. How about you? We have in our studio Dr. Girish Patel, a renowned psychotherapist. Dr. Patel, I welcome you to the studio. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti.
So last time we spoke about apple and the various health benefits apple can give us.
Yes.
And I was really amazed, and I've also included apple in my fruit basket.
One
for sure.
Should. Everybody should.
I'm going to eat an apple a day, and I'm sure our viewers will also do the same. Apple also happened to be your favorite fruit. But today I'm going to request you to talk about my favorite fruit. And guess what it is?
You only know.
Well, it's a very simple fruit, easily available in all seasons. It's the banana.
Oh, excellent.
Yes, I love bananas. And the main reason is, it's so easy. You just peel it and you can eat it. Ready-made.
Yes.
So tell us a few benefits.
No problem of pesticides.
Yes, no problem.
Because otherwise,
So I really enjoy bananas. And today I thought, let's find out. Because there are some fruits which come with a lot of myths. There are a lot of myths about bananas as well. Like some people say a banana can be very fattening, you know.
No.
And some people say you shouldn't eat more than one banana a day. So, and then they say if you eat two bananas, it can cause a little stomach upset. So, there are all these myths which I thought we will clarify today. And we will also understand, you know, how specifically banana is helpful.
True. If you want to dispel those myths to begin with, actually, it is good for your intestines.
Okay.
Because the bulk in it can act as an laxative. It won't cause constipation. It won't cause stomach upset.
Right.
Even though it kills bacteria to an extent, that is also another added benefit. And you would not put on weight if you reduce other things. You know, sometimes what happens, they continue with normal food plus maybe 4 or 5 bananas. Then you might put on weight.
Right.
Suppose if you eat 2 or 3 bananas and consider that each banana can be equal to one chapati or something.
Right.
So that much less if you are eating, then there will not be any problem. So rather you can lose weight.
So we have to balance it out. So we have to balance it out even with fruits. I think some people take fruits, thinking that we are eating the regular meals, what we are eating, and plus eating more fruit on top. So you have to compensate and you have to balance.
Yeah, and it gives no satisfaction. If you eat one banana in between whenever you are hungry, it will give you satisfaction as well. That's why it's good.
So we were going to also talk about, I wanted you to tell us what is contained in a banana.
Yeah. It has many things. Most important is potassium. Copper, magnesium, iodine, and very good thing, tryptophan is like amino acid, very good amino acid, which is a precursor of serotonin, which is a brain chemical.
Okay.
There are so many very good chemicals in banana.
So all these chemicals.
Even copper is there to an extent.
Right. So all these chemicals that you spoke about. How are these now specifically, how do they help the body?
True, correct.
Different organs, different systems in our body. Like you spoke about, it's very helpful in digestion.
True.
It will also kill the harmful bacteria. So they say even if somebody has a diarrhea, they tell you can eat some banana a little bit. And even for constipation, they say you can have banana because it will add bulk.
Bulk.
So like for digestion, it's quite understandable. But for other, how is it helpful?
It has a lot of potassium in it, which reduces blood pressure.
Okay.
So in blood pressure reduction, it is very good. And if you add honey to banana, then it becomes a good heart tonic.
Really?
It's good for heart health as well, with all the minerals in it.
But there is again another myth. People say that those who have diabetes should not consume banana.
But one or two banana will not increase your blood sugar. Rather, it can reduce.
Okay.
Once it brings satiety in you, and if you're not eating other food, then overall it will reduce your blood sugar.
So even
only
diabetics
thing, don't eat too much. Suppose now if you eat 3 banana together and then other food as well, then it will increase your blood sugar, otherwise not.
Okay. And so what are the other areas? Like you said that you know, it's got it is
on,
if
on
you have
heart,
it with honey, it's going to improve the heart health.
Yes. Then no, intestinal bacteria also it kills. No, so that way for intestinal health it is very good. No, banana has lots of calcium.
Yes.
So no, for the bone of your, you know, bone health, we can say to make your bone strong also it's very useful.
Right.
And no, my favorite is, I tell almost all patients, because the patients have depression, insomnia, one or other problem. So no, before sleep I say, with little milk you eat banana.
I mean, my grandfather says, if you eat banana with milk, you will put on weight very fast.
No, no, no. You will maintain, you will not put. Because the tryptophan would release serotonin and serotonin would induce good sleep. Even milk helps in having good sleep.
So, one banana at night with milk.
With milk and no, with balancing the other food.
Okay.
Then it's no very good for health.
So, like
I suggest practically all the patients.
So, like you had suggested last time, that if we have our dinner between 5 and 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. So, if you finished dinner by 7 p.m., mm-hmm. then maybe around 9 p.m. you can have some milk and a banana.
You can. Or suppose no, if you want that benefit of increasing those glial cells, then you should take even milk and banana early.
So
you should be really empty, you should be really empty for 12-13 hours, then only that benefit will come. But otherwise for a normal person this can be right. You have your dinner and before sleep, maybe half an hour or something, if you eat banana with milk, then it could help you in having a good restful sleep.
So banana is helping with digestion, it is helping to aid good heart health, it is also helping, you said, with depression and anxiety for good sleep. Any other benefits?
Yeah, in fact, no, banana tree, no, everything is good. Banana trunk, they have found that if you create a juice out of it, and then it kills many infections. You know, nowadays they don't use because so many, you know, antibiotics are there. But earlier, too, they used to use that juice for tuberculosis patients also. And there was very good result. I personally feel now also, still we should do. Because, no, then the need for antibiotic will reduce. Antibiotics definitely have added side effects. So, that juice, if can add to it, maybe say 20%, that is also beneficial.
Right. But some people, I think this is one tree, banana tree is one tree where all the parts of the tree are useful.
Banana leaf is used.
The leaf is used, the bark is used to make some vegetables. South Indians especially make a lot of curries out of it. Then the flower of the banana tree is used again for some vegetables. And I believe they taste really good as well.
Correct. Yeah, I have not tasted, but
it must taste very good. Even the leaf is used as a plate. You know, in South Indian homes, they eat food on a banana leaf.
Even though they wrap in rice and some, and then also steam it.
Yes.
And they say that it would release certain chemicals, which has anti-infective property.
Right. So, I think, again, this is one wholesome fruit. So, since it's my favorite fruit, I'm really happy. Because anyways, I eat a banana every day. And apple I wasn't, which I will now.
Correct, yeah. Even you can start your day with banana.
Yes, I do that most of the time.
So, then that filling effect will come.
Yes.
And then even if you don't take breakfast, it might be okay, or you can delay your breakfast.
Yeah, sometimes I feel that even taking one banana and maybe a few nuts, you feel like it's good enough to sustain you for 2 hours.
Correct. Yeah.
At least 2 hours, and even if you have to go for a workout, I think it's the best thing, the best energy bar you can have before a workout is a banana.
Banana, yeah. And another very important thing is for athletes, this picture which shows here. Right, because they need micronutrients in between. So, now if they eat banana before exercise, maybe banana after exercise, then they will get those micronutrients as well as cramps which are there. No, muscle cramps they tend to develop. That also will be prevented.
Yes, that is also very important. You know, sometimes when you're sleeping, you get a very painful cramp in your legs. And which they say is due to lack of hydration, if you're not drinking enough water. But I believe a banana really helps even in with those cramps.
With no potassium and other these micronutrients are there, it can be of great help.
Right. So, again, I would once again like to highlight. So, this banana milkshake, you say that it's not fattening?
No. Little bit if you take it is not fattening, rather it can help you in reducing your weight.
So it's okay if I have a banana milkshake?
Yeah. Okay. Even no banana peel, if you cut in small pieces and keep it on teeth for a while, then they say it's for no teeth whitening also, it's a good agent.
Yes. So I think every part of this fruit, from the peel to the fruit to the flower to the bark, everything is so useful. It's really a wonderful fruit. And then I think the best part is it's so economical.
Yeah.
Seasonal. You know?
True. So this
it's available.
The serious problem, no, they say that from where we'll bring all this money. This is a powerful answer for them.
Yes. So it's really wonderful to know that banana has so many benefits. Mm-hmm. Another very easily available fruit and very economical for the masses is papaya.
Papaya, true, very true.
And I've heard that papaya has a lot of health benefits.
Definitely.
Can we talk about a few today?
Correct, yeah. Very important of all, no, is a digestive property. No, there is an enzyme in papaya which helps in digestion. No, everybody can experiment. Suppose, no, sometime if you have eaten too much, and then if you eat, no, even little bit of papaya, you will feel that everything is getting settled. That, no, heaviness disappears. It's because of that enzyme which is there in papaya.
Okay. Mm.
Papaya is also very good to reduce your cholesterol level.
Okay. Mm.
Papaya can also help in reducing your blood pressure. No? Papaya can increase your immunity. No, your immune power also would increase with papaya. Papaya is good for even arthritis. So, there are so many benefits from papaya.
Again, is it okay to start your day with the papaya?
Yeah, you can. But no, this can be eaten after food also. That question was there in the beginning, no?
Yes.
So, maybe apple, papaya, even if you eat with food or after food also, it's okay. It will not have any negative effect. But even you can start your day also.
With papaya. Now, when we were talking about, again, specific illnesses which can be cured with fruits. When we come to papaya, what kind of illnesses can it cure?
It can be no good for eyes. Papaya is very good for skin also. Suppose, no, ripe papaya, if you just rub also, no, the skin becomes very good. Papaya is good for, as I said, no, to improve upon your immune response.
And these days, I believe it was all over the news also that if you get dengue fever, you can take the leaf of the juice of the papaya leaf.
It has some benefit, little bit towards that. Like, no, my opinion is little different. Sometimes what people do know, with dengue fever also, they will not take any other medicine, only papaya leaves. All these are complementary. If there is something else which is a mainstream medicine, we should take that also, as well as maybe papaya leaves, which will add to it.
Okay.
Don't take it in isolation.
Okay.
Otherwise, no, dengue can increase and it can have all that negative consequences.
Like you told us about the contents of a banana. What are the contents of a papaya?
Yeah, there are many. Like, no, it contains lots of vitamin C. In fact, no, it can be 200% of your daily requirement. It has magnesium as well. Then, no, that enzyme pepin I was telling you. Then there are even other micronutrients. Phosphorus is there. Even potassium, which helps in lowering your blood pressure. So, there are so many chemicals which are useful to our health.
And how are these chemicals helping us in preventing illnesses? You know, because like you say, vitamin C would prevent what kind of illnesses?
No, vitamin C is no ingredients for many things, like almost all our tissues. And very important part of vitamin C is it is not stored in the body. So, you need to take it frequently. Like now, vitamin A is stored in the body. Suppose if I have consumed once, then even if I don't consume for 2-3 days, it's okay. But for vitamin C, daily you have to consume it, maybe twice or thrice. Then only for our tissue repair and all the other mechanisms which are there in the skin, in our different tissues, it is of great help.
So, if you're saying that there is so much potassium contained in a papaya, then it must be very good for the bone health as well.
The bone health as well, as you know, reducing blood pressure when it helps.
So, it's almost equally, value-wise, it's good in potassium just like a banana.
Banana also, true. As well as, it helps in diabetes as well. Because, when you eat, again, that level of satisfaction comes. There's a lot of fiber in it. So, diabetic patient also can eat it without increasing their blood sugar level.
A lot of people consume papaya raw also. Mm-hmm. Like they have raw papaya salad and they make the curry out of papaya.
True.
So, tell us these are the unique benefits from
the raw papaya. When you eat as vegetables and other things, the content of vitamin C is also more.
Right.
Then it has also anti-infective, infection and reducing infection also papaya helps.
Because it boosts your
immune system. So, also it is good.
Are there any side effects to eating papaya?
Anything too much can be harmful. Actually, papaya, even if you eat more, that immediate blotting of stomach and all won't come because it has a digestive property. But still, ultimately it has some calories. So, if your calorie content increases, then there can be harmful effect. Otherwise, no.
So, any person with any kind of disease can consume papaya?
Yeah.
There
may not be the specific benefit. The specific benefit, as I mentioned, even for heart patient, it is good. But specific benefit may not come. But still, it will definitely add to it. And those, all fruits are good that way. Even for cancer, all fruits are good because it has those antioxidants, phytochemicals, all that helps to cancer patient as well. Papaya is also very good for prevention of Alzheimer. Even if somebody has Alzheimer, it is good because the mechanism behind Alzheimer is oxidative stress. And papaya helps in reducing that oxidative stress. So, it also helps in Alzheimer patients.
So, doctor, we've spoken about different fruits and how they have various benefits for our health. Mm-hmm. And there is another question which was coming in my mind. Normally when we change our diet a little, mm-hmm. when we go from eating spicy food mm-hmm. and oily foods, and when we switch to a fruit-rich diet, mm-hmm. how does it have an effect on your thoughts, mm-hmm. on your mind, on the internal health of your body? Mm-hmm. If you can just tell us why people feel this change, why people feel this difference, mm-hmm. switching the diet from a heavy diet to a fruit-rich diet. Mm-hmm. So, if you can just tell us.
Yeah, it can be explained in two ways. One can be the medical answer. Medical answer is those spicy food or a heavy food, they are stimulants. So, they will stimulate your nervous system. For a while, you might feel good, but then that stimulating effect also can come along with it. There can be anger, jealousy, lust, many other things. Now, apart from medical answer, the second aspect is it has that soothing effect as well. Fruit-rich diet will contain lot of tryptophan, serotonin, other micronutrients, which has no peace-giving effect.
Right.
Plus, because the fruits have a life energy, all the fruits, they are as such living. So, they have that life force in it. Whereas the other food which we eat is a dead food, which has no life energy in it.
Correct.
So, when you eat fruits, you immediately feel that your life energy is becoming better. Only thing, you should eat with awareness. Not that you are watching TV and also eating, then you will not be able to experience that subtle benefit of having better life energy.
Correct.
So that way, no, when you eat fruits, you really mentally also feel good. And then, no, even in practicing meditation or leading a peaceful life, having less anxiety, less stress, this fruit diet can be of great help.
Thank you so much, Doctor, for sharing with us the benefits of these easily available fruits.
Fruit.
You know, one is banana and papaya. Both are very economical, easily available, and with enormous health benefits. So thank you so much for sharing with us today. And, you know, we take it for granted, these things, that yes, fruits are good for health. But I think with awareness now, we need to include these fruits in our diet. And I'm sure it will have a positive impact on our viewers. We look forward to our viewers eating healthier now.
Fruit.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti.
So I think, my viewers, if we are ready to make this conscious shift, you know, from just eating anything, move to eating with awareness and eating life-giving foods. Life-giving foods, all fruits, all vegetables, and, you know, economic fruits, something which is available so readily, it is seasonal. If we make this conscious shift, we can definitely prevent so many health problems. I'll see you very soon. Until then, thank you and Om Shanti. Meditation in